Thank you. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, chat. It's up, guys. Like, it's up. Your boy got the gamer, and you know what time it is. Final Fantasy 16. So let's start. Guys, a little heads up. Next week, on the 14th to the 15th, I won't be here. I'll be going in a anime convention that day for those 3 days, so won't no streaming those days, guys. Sorry, I apologize for that. Yeah, I've been waiting for years to go to.
Research could continue apace, but my fertilizer is critical tomorrow before the next.
I've been waiting for year for since last year because I couldn't go last year because I had to take care of some stuff. But this year, I'm 100% going, guys. So I can't wait for the anime convention in here in my area.
What do you want? Say so myself. No scratches, right? You can thank me later. Yeah, I should do you.
There we go, I got Blackthorn. I got a new weapon again, which is awesome. Eric Stone. Replaying a previous stage clear word, but we can still perform reaction. Okay. Interesting.
What do you want?
To say farewell. We're leaving.
Good decision. Better that than buried out there in the black. You've got a lot to thank that girl for, you know.
I know. And I will.
Now, what do you really want? We both know when you don't come in for conversation.
Sorry about that, guys. Give me a second. Alright. No. Reduce Rogue's Gaming cooldown by 2.7 seconds. That's pretty good, but that's a lot of money.
Off you go, then. And best of luck.
I should probably say thank you to Gav, too.
$389, so this is good. This is a big shift. Yeah, I think I'll master that. That one will be good for me. Anything else? I'm good.
So your mind's made up, is it?
You'll be leaving for Rosario this morning.
Back down memory lane, eh? Rosario ain't what she used to be, Clive. Not since the Imperials moved in. A sign of trouble, you make straight for Martha's Rest and ask for the landlady. She's a friend of the cause. Tell her you're with Sid, and she'll help you out.
Understood. Thank you, Gav.
Yeah.
I'd be lost without you.
Yeah, I'm just doing my job. No need to make such a fuss. You take care, alright? Oh, crap, goodbyes. Where's Sid when you need him?
Give him my regards when he gets back.
I will.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Ready, my lady.
Ready.
The reeds, three reeds. Rising, water, transform one's fertile farmland, farmland into morass, redeeming its night and horrible to all leeches, but leeches and lizards. Gross.
Area. It's been 13 years.
This breeze, the smell of the grass, it's just as I remember it.
You haven't been back either.
I couldn't. Brand did keep a close watch on each other in the Imperial Army and get beheaded just for knowing a deserter. The only way out was on a mission.
I see.
Mostly I was afraid. Afraid to get back.
I know.
But I'm here now. That's it at the top of the hill, must be Martha's Rest. Gav said the man hates her friend.
But can we say the same about patrons?
Imperials don't tend to take well to those with my mark. If anyone asks, I'm a branded soldier, sworn to protect my noble mistress. Thank you.
after what happened at Phoenix Gate, it didn't seem the highest priority.
Oi! Stop and give me an hand! Here! You couldn't give me an hand, could you?
Typical. Bloody bearer. Just when I thought my luck had changed. Look, ever a crumb of crystal than an empty hand, I suppose. So it pains me to use another man's branded. Here, you understand me, don't you? I need your help.
Jeez.
Bastard Earth must have got away from my cargo, and now they've got me surrounded. It's very late as it was. I've got something special needs delivering before the rest. I dare not leave my cart unbending. You couldn't run it up to Martha's rest for me, could you? Needs to get there quick, mind.
Fine.
That's the spirit. All right. Here. You hand that to the stable master and no one else. I know a little something for it. If he gives it to you, pass it along to your master by way of thanks. Be off with you then. And don't go taking any detours on the way.
Martha's Rest. That's one of old brand. Be the stable master. I was asked to deliver this to you.
This is for me, right enough. Not sure what some bearer is doing bringing it to me, though. Where's that fool of a peddler have got to?
He couldn't come himself. His cart surrounded by wild chocobos.
Sounds about right.
Oh, and there's one more thing, guys. Sorry. Jimmy double stream today. This one and Monster Hunter World with my friends later on, so look for that at 4:30.
Birds come running from miles around. Don't get me wrong. We're a fine investment for a savvy merchant, especially around these parts. But you can't get greedy, because our mutual friend is learning the hard way. Still, I got my wares, that's all that matters. Be sure to pass your master my regards.
Excuse me, do you happen to be the landlady? Depends who's asking, and why they have an imperial bearer with them. For protection, which hopefully won't be needed, if you can advise me on the safest route to the west. It's your friend here I'd be worried about. Bearers don't have an easy time with it in those areas. People straddling the landlord in might attract the wrong kind of attention. If he gets nabbed, it might be to end well for you either.
Then we'll just have to stay out of the malicious way. Gav said he might be able to help us.
Follow me. Sorry for before. Can't be too wary of strangers asking questions in our game. I'm Arthur, an old friend of Sid's. He said he had high hopes for a bearer who joined recently. I expect that's you. So, where is it you're headed?
The Phoenix Gate. We have questions that we need answering.
Is that so? Well, if you want to avoid the garrison, the road through Eastville's your best bet. Or it would be. Bridge and collapsed. What a blooming nuisance it is. We've had no trade with the village for weeks. I did ask our contractor to take a look at it, but he went out on another job. He hasn't come back. Do you think something might have happened to him? Fingers crossed he's just taking his time. He'll turn it into a thing about.
We'll find him. Make sure he's safe. We both need that bridge repaired. Your carpenter sounds like the man to do it.
I see why Sid's got such a soft spot for you. If you could, I'd be in your debt. You said that he went out on a job?
Right. He went down into the marshes to check on another bridge. The one by the Fallen Gate.
The marshes were dangerous at the best of times. We should hurry.
There's a ladder to the side of the gate. That's the quickest way down, if you're ahead of the heights. His name is Bernard. Should you find him well, tell him Martha sent you, and that he's wanted at the bridge to Eastpool. To the marshes, then. Let's find that ladder.
Good, honest work. Here's the gate. But that must be the ladder.
It was for his old stables here.
Yeah.
bridge. Come on. There he is.
Oh, I love that. That's a key combo.
Not at all. You're Bernard the Carpenter, yes?
I am. I didn't realize my name was not so likely.
I'm a friend of Martha's. She asked us to come and find you.
Well, I'm very grateful for it. I just finished collecting these piles when I turn around and I see a gang of slavering monsters looking at the feast on my flesh. If you hadn't come when you did, I'd have been snipped into strips by now.
We're just glad you're safe.
I best go give my regards to the landlady then, eh?
Actually, she asked that if we found you, we should beg you make haste to repair the bridge to Eastpool.
Of course. I said I'd take a look at it, but I please slip my mind. I'd head up there straight away. The trusses are still sturdy. It's just a matter of replacing the stringers and relighting the deck. I'll have it done in no time.
Thank you, Bernard. We were hoping to take the road to Eastpool ourselves. We're very grateful for your help. I'm sorry for asking this of you after what you've been through.
I owe you my life. Fixing a bridge is the least I can do. Thank you, my lady. And you too, sir. You're with Sid, yeah? Me and him, we go way back. Not as far as Martha mine, but far enough. I see. Well, I best get cracking then. You go let Martha know I'm all right. She'll have her bridge back soon enough.
You will.
The bridge will be fixed when it's fixed, right?
Hi, you're back. What happened? Did you find Bernard?
We did.
He's fine, and he'll have the bridge to Eastpool repaired soon.
Thank the Founder for that.
It was lucky we found you when we did. The creatures out there are not to be trifled with.
It's the Blight's fault. They'd nothing to eat in the north, so they come down here hunting for food.
He can't keep going out alone. I'll have to arrange a guard for him. But anyway, thank you. I don't have a lot to offer in return, but you're welcome to rest here until the repairs are finished. We'd be delighted.
Can I get you a drink or anything while you wait? Flag of Imperial Gold, perhaps? Tastes like swill, but it'll sink your thirst.
No, thank you. I prefer the truth. Why there are so few bearers around here.
Yes, there were more of them when we were young. Far more.
Is this the Empire's doing? Have they been sent away?
Yeah, Blasted Agents or Arathan. Seems the miners at Drake's Head are having a hard time keeping up with demand of late, so the bearers make up the shortfall. And Wasa used to donate crystals like sugar plums even down here in the provinces, not anymore. Nowadays, they'll jump at any excuse to confiscate our bearers so they can be put to work elsewhere. I always knew the Empire treated their grand like shit, but after seeing it with my own eyes. For 9 Aldoons. A bloody bearer. Oh, you poor thing. You gave it to the constables then. Just left it at the garrison by. Let them deal with it. Couldn't wait to be rid of the blasted thing. Been wanting it gone since the moment I found out. Well, it's all dealt with now. So no harm done, eh?
Mum, you weren't my brother, was you?
No. But you'll have one soon enough. You just have to be patient, all right?
Wow. Jesus, that's crazy.
Bearers may have been looked down on back in Archduke Owen's day, but they were still human beings. Now they've fallen so far, a beggar wouldn't spit on them. You're not drinking, do me a favour and take that to the Abbey. There's a darkness at the heart of this world, and I'd have you see it.
And we'll see it at an Abbey.
Bladamond Abbey, on the shore of Solowise Bay. The abbot there is a friend. Tell him Martha sent you, and he'll show you what I mean.
Understood. Anything catch your eye?
Jesus, 20k for that. I'm glad.
Oh,
is it? No,
fresh
stuff,
fresh stuff, stick, fresh stuff.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah.
She's only 6 gil. That's not even much.
There's the Abbey. What darkness awaits us within, I wonder.
Let's go and see.
I'm afraid the Abbey is not open for public prayer. Rodrigo, go with you.
We came to offer a donation from Martha.
It's all right. I'm here.
Who are these people?
Martha's bearers. She entrusted them to my care, that I might ease their suffering. To the extent that I can. For the time they have.
Oh shit, are you petrified? What the fuck?
So they are cast aside. There is nothing either Martha or I can do to change that, but we can at least strive to make their final hours a little more bearable. Have faith, my son, for you shall rise again and find the happiness denied you in this life. Thank you, Father.
Oh shit, he became petrified. Jeez, that's messed up.
for the medicine you so kindly brought. Now that their final moments may be moments of peace. When next you see Martha, pray tell her that two more have succumbed. We should get back to Martha's breast.
Yes.
Can I laugh? That's trouble, guys. I don't have to do much. Jeez, most of these people are just whole. Some of them are just
Ah, you're back. Thanks for taking care of that.
Yeah,
oh shit.
Two more have succumbed.
I see. Come upstairs. You know, eh?
I've seen plenty of bearers die on the battlefield. But never like that.
And all because they were born different. The powers that be can't take away their gift, so they strip them of their humanity instead. Oh, there's plenty who pity a bearer's blood. But so long as we're content to sit around weeping for those on whose broken backs we're carried, we ain't gonna change nothing. And so you lend Sid your strength. What little of it I have. Use the profits from this place to buy the poor buggers.
So when the abbot told us the bearers were yours?
Aye, they're my property, at least by law. Any still fit to work fetch a price beyond my means. All I could do is care for those who have past mend. But it's not all doom and gloom. When it's finished fixing that bridge for you, you can carry on to Eastbourne then. I've got questions that need answering, ain't you? Well, I wish you luck.
Thank you, Martha.
Oh, I almost forgot. Sid and I have other friends in Rosaria. Wear this and we'll know you for one of us.
Still up to you.
I know that you will always be welcome here. You were right, Sid. It really is them. Lord Rosfield and Lady Warwick have come back to us. And long may they stay.
Dang, she knew. To hell.
Sid.
Ah, oh, Clive. You're not where I left you.
Hurt your hand.
Oh, shit.
With a thousand little lightning bolts.
He's become petrified too.
Think of it as my decoration for a long service of exemplary misconduct.
Thank you, Sid, for everything.
If you want to leave, that's your lookout. I'm sure you'll have a long and happy life together if you stay out of my way.
Damn. Is she talking about Betty?
For a while, I didn't think I could. But just because you think something doesn't make it true.
Sid.
I'm now saying it. Just a conceited old fool. I talk about people forging their own futures. But instead of handing them the armor, I beat them with my own. And if no brother wants to listen to what you've got to say, you might as well keep your gob shut. Clive, I will say this. You're not a monster. You're the same man you've always been. Accept that, and you may yet escape your fate.
My fate.
Look, you've had a hard life, and I don't see it getting much easier. You might not be able to save anyone else, but at the very least, you can save yourself. Sorry we didn't get a chance to talk. I trust you take good care of the boy.
Yes, I will.
Is that the last of it?
Aye.
The best I've got then. I would want to keep them later.
Let's do some side quests, guys, before we do that.
Dear, you're that bearer who works for Martha, aren't you? Can you give me a hand? Curse my luck, I dropped my crystal off a cliff into the bloody swamp by an utter fool. Now, I've not got your knack, yet I need that jar to chill my fish if I'm to take him to market. It's just a short climb down. I'll make it worth your while.
I can't promise anything.
You just promise to look. Ah, there may be one thing I failed to mention about the crystal. A creature might have already claimed it.
Who mined it?
Or I eaten it, but only mine, I have to understand. There were a lot of bog crabs down there. Nasty buggers, then.
Sounds like I need to break a few shells.
Oh, don't worry, there weren't too many of them. A veritable walk in the marsh, as they say. The ladders, right over there.
Oof.
yours, I presume.
You found it, old Samuel! Any longer out in the sun and my catch would have made for poor eating indeed.
Be more careful next time. Oh, I will, I promise.
No point casting my nets in the morning if I'm without crystal to see the catch to town. There was a time honest taxpaying folk could get new ones whenever they wanted. Can now, though, not for love nor money. Crystals are scarce, and the Empire tightens its purse strings more every day. Lose this little beauty again, and I might as well scrap the nets and take to begging.
Sounds serious. What happened? Not so much what happened, but what might. They discovered he's a bearer, see? And now, one of his erstwhile friends and neighbours wants to see him clapped in chains. Where is this bearer? Wasn't fool enough to wait for the Imperial to arrive. Poor sod took to the road, left his own life behind. They'll be after him before long. I need to find him and get him to safety fast. Here. You have the time and the intonation. I could do with a hand. Will you help me find him? Of course. We bearers have to look out for each other. Thank you, Clive. With your help, you might catch up with him yet. His name's Norris. We need to find him and get him to Martha before the Imperials sniff it out.
You found him yet? You wouldn't catch a bastard standing around clucking like old hens. That fucking snake played me false, acted like he was one of us, and the old time he was one of them. We need him caught and handed over to the Imperials. Hanging's too good for him. Well, go on then. If he gets away, I'll see you fit for a noose.
All right, Ronald. We were just leaving. Look, this one's here to help. I was just filling him in.
Send a bearer to catch a bearer, is it? Not bloody likely. That's it. I'll find the bastard myself.
Come on now, Ron. It's dangerous out there. We wouldn't want you to come to any harm.
You want something done right. You don't send a bearer.
Clive, this might take a while. You start hunting our man, and I'll be along once I put Ronald's mind at ease. Someone said they saw Norris heading for the Fallen Gate. Maybe you could ask if anyone over that way knows anything. We have to find him. Don't let him slip through our grasp. I better find this Norris before Ronald takes matters into his own hands. Bearers are hardly difficult to spot. What do you mean about being played false, I wonder?
He was all right already, and he had a lantern with him for some reason. Never known him to stay out after dark.
He was making for the marshes then. All right, thank you.
He barely up to step out.
Ah, shit. Fucking game. Gosh, stuck on real.
That's one of my friends.
We can't go far. Better keep my eyes peeled. lantern. The one Norris was carrying, no doubt. At least I know which way he went. Someone made short work of them. But if that someone was Norris. Norris, I presume.
Please be me.
We never branded. So that's how you stayed hidden.
Well, I'll send you after me, Diddy. Set an imperial dog on his best friend. But we were so close. I'll never forget the hatred in his eyes. But it doesn't matter now. I will not become a slave. This one bearer to another, please. Don't do this. You know how they treat our kind.
Ronald didn't send me. One of Martha's men did. He wanted to make sure you were safe.
I don't understand.
Martha takes in Maris. She's a friend. You can trust her. Believe me.
I never knew. I can't say I'm surprised then. She has a kind heart. Kinder than most.
Just wait here and stay out of sight. We'll be among friends soon enough.
Thank you. There's few would have been so kind. And sorry. You're no Imperial Doc. Far from it.
I've been called worse. I found a lantern back there. I assume it's yours.
Thanks. I dropped it when those creatures attacked me. But, if I'm honest, it wasn't all that sorry to be rid of it. Wrong, David.
Alright. I'll keep hold of it. I might be able to use it to put an end to the Imperial Surge before it begins. There, without a breath. For so many years, and to be betrayed by a friend.
If I'm leaving this to a bearer, I'll go myself.
There you are, Clive. How goes the search?
Well, branded. Have you found the bastard yet?
Only what was left of him. A corpse torn apart by monsters. And this.
Let me see that. It can't be.
Shall we consider that the end of the matter, then? Or do you need to see a body?
No, I mean, I've no use for bearer bones. He's dead. Let that be an end to it. I wish those whose job it was had done what it was supposed to do and spotted him sooner. Let the bearer go about without a brand. It's not right, I tell you. Who want anything to do with me now, eh? There goes the bearer loving else, eh? I'll be a laughing stock.
True, Clive. Norris, really, he's alive. You'll find him in the heart of the marshes. He's expecting you.
Ah, you crafty. You did the right thing. Thank you. Not much considering, but please, take this.
Jeez, all out. Skill points.
Why are you the
pushing in more monsters down the net. I dare say we'll be seeing a few along the way.
Then we shall have to keep our wits about this.
Excellent. Keep your distance, boys. Excuse me, are you that lady of yours? Curse my branded. I'm kinda happy if you will hold your leash. That's just what we talk about you, Barry. One of Martha's, are you? Good. She won't begrudge me to you seeing that. While there's woman's about. We tried dealing with them ourselves. We now bait, which we might swoop in and slaughter that. But we didn't expect the path to be quite so bloody big.
I expect the blight drove them here. They must have fled their homes for greener pastures.
We'd hope their weak bellies might make them easy prey. We'd have made them mean instead. Arthur's no fool. She must see some in you. Do us a favor and get rid of them, will you?
Jeez.
All right. I suppose those wolves pose a threat to everyone.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. I wager the greedy bastard just stood over yonder, finishing off our bait. When you've seen to every last one of them, go and speak to my friend over the bridge. Bryce, his name is. You want to know if he's safe to come across. Well, off you go then.
Friend asked me to get rid of the wolves, so I got rid of the wolves.
You'd have me believe a single bearer slit the entire pack. And again, if you didn't, you wouldn't be on this side of the bridge. Other than me, you're a tough one, aren't you?
Oh, Frederick!
You woolly bastard. I never thought to pit beast against beast like that.
Served us well, bearer.
no more side quests, right? Okay, good.
Look, the windmills. That must be Eastwood.
I remember coming here with Lord Murdoch when I was young. This area seemed a very different place back then.
Quiet, isn't it?
Yes.
Clive Rossfield. It's me, Hannah, Robin Murdoch's wife.
Lady Hannah.
Oh, I knew it was you. You haven't changed at all. And Lord Martha is in jail too. It's so good to see you both again.
It's good to see you too, Lady Hannah.
If you have time, you simply must come back to the house. I haven't much to offer, but what is mine is yours.
Oh my goodness, I'm tired, guys. There's lots of hate working at night. I wish I could change it.
And you have been wandering the world ever since. I can well understand fleeing from those iron blood brutes. Oh, to take to the road at such a tender age.
Do you think you will stay here in Eastpool? Rosalith still enjoys the Mother Crystal's blessing, does it not? You could always move. This house holds a lot of memories for me. So long as I can live here in peace, here I shall stay. Not that it matters. The capital is closed to civilians by order of the Duchess. Or should I say, Her Imperial Majesty. Annabella's marriage to the Emperor of Sandbrick heralded a great many changes here.
Yes. Of course.
Oh, forgive me. I didn't mean to.
Please. There is nothing to forgive. Would my mother not make an exception for you and your husband? Surely she would not refuse the Lord Commander.
You haven't heard, then. Rodney passed away on the night of the fire.
Oh shit. Clive just... Clive remembers now.
I'm sorry.
Clive. My poor child. You're pale.
This traveling must have taken its toll. I insist you rest. We can talk later. Sure, you don't want to sleep inside.
I can't. Not after what I did.
Lady Hannah said she would prepare a change of clothes for you in the morning. She really has been very kind.
It was only Joshua that kept me going. I swore that I would avenge his death, that I would kill his killer. That was the only thing that gave my life any meaning. But if it was me who killed Joshua, and Murphy, and all the others, then why the hell am I still breathing?
I ask myself the same. When I fought, hundreds died. There were so many bodies, so many lives cut short in their prime. That day in Dalmatia, I wanted to join them. I wanted it all to end. I couldn't bear it anymore. If living meant being that, better to be just another body. I said a prayer to Letia, and that prayer was answered. You came back to me. The heavens must have a plan for us. We should get some rest. Good night, Clive. Sleep well.
Thank you, Mayanna. Perhaps now people will not flee beside me.
You look just like Elwyn did when he was your age.
How did you come to have some of my father's old clothes?
Well, before Elwyn became Archduke, our families would often summer together. He and Rodney were like brothers. These clothes have been in a wardrobe for years, collecting cobwebs along with everything else.
Sorry for depriving you of your memories.
Not at all. It's what your father would have wanted. They suit you well.
Thank you,
Lady Hannah.
most kind.
No, I should thank you. It may only have been for a short while, but seeing you again took me back to happier times. Very well, my lord and lady.
And you, Lady Anna. North. They should take us all the way to Phoenix Gate. Let's go. You're buying Iron Shadow. You're his firstborn, Clive Rosfield. You must take him. You can't fool me, my lord. You're the very image of your father. And that would be true even if you weren't wearing his clothes. The self-same garments Hannah was keeping for you, if I'm not mistaken. She always swore that she would never part with them until the day Elwyn's sons returned. And now that day has come. Why, you'll be able to take your bearers back as well. I was a child when last I came to Eastport. I didn't recognize him.
Oh, I'd be surprised if you recognized anything at all. Much has changed since Rosaria fell to the Empire. Not least for the bearers, who once served her noble families. When the Iron Blood sacked Rosalith 13 years back, many who lost their masters fled here in search of sanctuary.
And never returned.
Aye. The plan was to send them home once we won back the capital. But then the Imperials arrived. Rosaria became a province of Sandrek. The duchy was dissolved, and they no longer had any home to return to. Back in your father's day, any bearer who lost their master became a ward of the duchy. We'd hand them over to the sheriffs, and they'd be assigned a position. When we saw how the Empire treated their branded, we knew that wasn't an option. So they've been here ever since. And now you want to give them to me. They're yours by right, Lord Rosfield. Bequeathed you by your late father. And they'd be better off serving you than hiding here. Indeed, many of them used to serve your house and still consider the Rosfields their masters.
I'm no one's master. Not anymore. They wouldn't be safe with me.
I understand. You'll forgive an old man his fanciful notions, been daydreaming for too long. But still, I would ask a favor of you, a small mercy.
If it is within my power. One of the bearers is an elderly fellow who still swears absolute loyalty to Archduke Elwyn. I don't ask that you take him into your service, only that you meet with him. Let him see that Elwyn's son still lives, and that he's as fine a man as his father ever was. It would be my honor. Thank you, my lord. He sits by the well most days, watching the people go about their business. If you could show him your face, I would be most grateful.
Jeez. More quests before the main quest? I'll save it for now.
Yeah, that's very different, you know. Especially dressed like that. Come on, let's go and meet that bearer.
Well, guys, I'll be ending my stream for today. I will see you guys later in 3 hours. In 3 hours or so. For Monster Hunter World. This is Godlet Gamer signing out, guys, and have a great